The following program is brought to you by Element 14, the electronics community where you can connect and collaborate with top engineers from around the world. Join now at element14.com/presents.
Hello, and welcome back to Workbench Wednesdays. My name is James, and on this show, we talk about the tools found on your electronics workbench. Like many data sheets, looking at one for a multimeter can be confusing. You might see terms like digits, counts, and accuracy stated with all kinds of math symbols. In this episode, we talk about what all of those mean, which you should care about, and how they relate to a DMM's accuracy. The digit specification relates to the DMM's display. Here are some examples. Starting with a 3.5 digit screen, there are three digits that can go from 0 to 9. The fractional or half digit typically only displays a 0 or 1. So in this case, the meter's display can count from 0 to 1,999. The next example is a 5.5 digit screen. There are five whole digits plus one fractional that only displays 0 or 1. The last example is a meter with 3.75 digits. It has three whole digits, but what about this 3/4 digit? Well, this number is where things get fuzzy. Manufacturers don't always seem to agree on what 0.75 means, except it means more than one. In the case of my Multicomp Pro meter, it means 0 through 5. Also, check this out. Newark's website classifies this meter as a 3.75 digit. However, the datasheet says 3 5/8. Confusing, right? Well, the good news is you can look at something else that gets specified to understand how the display works, and that is the maximum counts. Up until this point, I left out the decimal. The meter's display does not care about the order of magnitude. It just displays 3 or 4 or 5 digits. The measurement range determines where the decimal point shows up on the screen. Using this Tenma auto-ranging meter, I manually set it to the 6-volt range. It has 3.75 digits, and in this range, the maximum it can display is 5.999 volts. The 999 is the 3 whole digits, and the 5 is the 3/4 or 5/8 digit. Now, by increasing the voltage, the meter must change to its 60-volt range to display anything above 6.2 volts. But that range means the tens place wastes one entire digit, so 6.300 volts gets displayed as 06.29. We have lost one digit of precision from the display. You might have noticed that so far I have only used the word precision. Even though digits and counts are typical specs for a meter, they do not represent the accuracy of a DMM. So, while you look at the next title card, consider this for a moment. What is the difference between accuracy and precision? Okay, did you give the question some thought? I ask because it is very easy to mix up the terms, so we need to define them separately. Accuracy is how correct a measurement is, while precision is how well it is displayed. Up to this point, we talked about digits and counts, which relate to the display value, which means it covers the precision of a DMM. While related to digits, accuracy depends on the analog to digital converter and the components that sit in front of it. Once again, we look to the datasheet to see how well a DMM can measure a signal. Notice that different voltage ranges and functions have different accuracies. So for the 6-volt range, it has an accuracy of plus or minus 0.7% plus 3. Okay, what does that mean? Well, it tells us how to calculate the range that might get displayed for specific measurement. For example, let's assume a perfect 3.3-volt signal. We have to add and subtract 0.7% of that reading to get a range of 3.276 and 3.323. Now the plus 3 of the spec means extending the least significant digit by 3 counts, which turns the final range into 3.273 and 3.326 volts. For a handheld DMM, this accuracy is typical. I looked at another brand's handheld that has 3.5 digits and it had a similar rating. So I want to compare it to my bench DMM, which has 5.5 digits, but a much tighter accuracy. It is specified as 0.015% of the reading plus 0.004% of the range, which is way better than a handheld. For our example 3.3 volt signal, it would require the 20 volt range, which means the math works out to be from 03.299 and 03.301. Keep in mind that because we use the 20 volt range for this measurement, we effectively lost one digit of precision, but we still ended up with a much tighter range or more accuracy. So in general, a meter with more digits is probably more accurate, but digits and counts alone do not tell the full story. Also, don't forget price. Yes, the bench meter is much more accurate than the handheld, but it costs hundreds of dollars compared to a handheld, which could be less than $50. As I wrap up, I have a final comment. Do not get too bent out of shape in comparing digits, counts, and even accuracy. Just because one meter is 3.5 digits and another is 3.75, it does not mean the meter with more is automatically 7% more accurate. While more digits means more precision, you have to check further into the datasheet to compare the accuracy. And then consider how you plan to use the meter. Unless you have a specific need when comparing DMMs, I say focus on the form factor, its measurements, and your budget first. Then use accuracy and precision as the tiebreakers. Over on the Element 14 community, you can find show notes for this episode. They include links to the products shown, along with some additional DMM resources. If you have questions about accuracy or precision, that is the best place to ask me. While you're there, you might want to check out other parts of Element 14. For example, road test reviews are a great place to see reviews written by the community about gear like test tools and evaluation boards. In fact, any community member can apply to receive free stuff in exchange for a review. My name is James and I thank you for watching. For now, it is time for me to get back to accurately making precision measurements to the half digit on my electronics workbench.